centimeters. So five plants from the top. So here's one, tube, kind of a fancy tube that has different little O-rings that keep the solution where it's supposed to be. And then a neat little actuator that allows the O-rings to open up and the solution to come up into the area where the plant was stored.
2 minutes behind, so it must be a server time.
And there's different tubes with different solutions, and each of these plants is of some different genetic strain of the plant. So they know exactly what they want to see within each solution and within each type of plant.
Okay, good news. Thank you.
And essentially, the solutions are different forms of preservatives.
Okay. And Jess, if you're still there, we wanted to give you guys a heads up that we need a hands-off of SSC4 during the mosquito
outbreak.
I'm going to take you now, release the camera, and take up into the cupola so you can see how the world looks. Really cool right now is not only are we looking at the world, but look what else is out here. Canid arms poised above the cupola, ready to grab dragon and release it to go back to the earth. Makes a nice focal object while you're taking pictures of the world. That's a crater. The visible part of it is more than 100 kilometers across, and it's in Canada, in Quebec, just close to the Saguenay River. It's called Manicouagan. It's a regular, familiar sight as you're coming across Canada. We're over the water right now, but I see a cloud that's kind of an interesting shape. So I'm going to grab the 180. Here's a 180 millimeter lens. Let me check my settings. Oh, good. Line it up. Focus super sharp. Get it very careful. Hold the camera still. Take one or two. They're digital. You're not burning film. Better to have slightly too many than not enough. Coming across the Atlantic and coming up on Africa. I can see a few of the islands in the foreground. Get the wide angle, see if we can get the whole edge and flow of the Sahara as we come up on Africa. The clouds are really nice right now. They're sort of coming at me like a burst, focusing the eye in on what we're looking at. We've got Canada Arm in the foreground. It's a nice picture. A lot of people ask, how come you don't see stars in the picture? It's the same as your eyes. If the camera is set so that its iris is wide enough that it can take all the light reflected from the world, then the faint light from the stars just gets washed out. The stars are always there during the day. You can't see them because your pupils are scrunched right down, just like the iris or the eyeball on the camera. Same problem. That's why we don't see stars during the space pictures unless we really work at it.
to get us a little better edge would be helpful. If you could tweak the holder or the sample, bump it a little bit, that would be helpful.
Will do. And if you have monitor two, you can see that that we still have real good focus on the waft in the fabric.
Yeah, copy that. We probably don't need that at this time, Don.
Bending moment on this, I'm going to make sure that it doesn't go through the frame that holds the fabric. I've got it held like this with my pliers, and I'm going to push with my fingers right next to where the pliers are, so that way the bending moment does not go through the frame.
It sounds like a good plan.
Yep.
And the first three are the ones that are the finickiest for me.
Okay, Alpha 1 and 2, come on.
I'm ready. Not the defense, right. Here we go. Looking good, Billy Ray.
1.
2.
Got me to hold up, Dave?
Nope. The next one's the tricky one. Just a minute. I'll take it, you can start putting it in.
Bravo.
Smith. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay. All four coming up.
Good.
Fire away.
Okay.
Okay, the other way. Next. 3.
Okay.
Back. Have you ever wondered how we measure our body mass in space? Well, we use two different mass measuring devices. The Russians have one, and we have one right behind me. We call it SLAM-D, but let me demonstrate it for you.